Welcome to the Papa Bear Show, and today I'm doing a video for the interview I did with Ash Maczko, the co-creator and writer of Squarriors, which is this comic right here, which I have multiple copies. But yeah, I think it's like my comic of the year 2014 so far. I can't wait for issue number 2, which I think is due in March. Well, that's what I read, so I'm not 100% sure. So yeah, so I contacted Ash to do an interview. He agreed, and I sent him the question. He answered by email. So yeah, so let me go ahead and do this. I hope you like my little setup with the pictures and all the random. So if you don't understand what I'm saying, you can read it. So the first question I asked him was, who is Ash Maczko and Ashley Witter? Ashley Witter is the incredibly talented artist who has done projects such as the Twilight graphic novels, Anne Rice's Interview with a Vampire, Anne Rice's Wolf Gift, Bloodthirsty, Fantasy Flight, Netrunner, CCG, and of course Squires. I, Ash, I'm just a nobody who wanted to write a comic book about squirrels. Where did the idea of Squires come from? I've always enjoyed the sentient animal stories. I like how fantastic the world must seem to animals. Every day of their lives is full of danger and wonder. Why squirrels and not mice, rats, snakes, etc.? There are all manner of creatures featured in Squires. I like how everything revolves around squirrels, but there's also some other species of animal in there. Will they play a bigger role in the comics, or are they simply sidekicks? There is no central character in Squires. It focuses on the entire world these tribes exist in. That focus will shift as other stories develop. However, you can count on the majority to follow the lives of the main protagonist, the Tinkin. The post-apocalyptic comics are pretty hot right now. Is it something that pushed you towards that, or it had to be that way for the story to fall in place? I don't consider Squires post-apocalyptic. For the remaining creatures, this is a genesis. This is a story about how things start, not what happens after it ends. Also, is there any chance to seeing any more creators in the near future? It's hard to say exactly, but creators do play a role in the ongoing series. Let's leave it like that. The cat featured in the first page of the comics, is it a concept that will reoccur? Cats and other animals have always been part of the story. Wormwood, the cat featured in the beginning of issue number 1, was a character from the Immortalize Your Pet perk from the Kickstarter campaign. It's based off of a friend of ours' cat. Right now, we have a few more pets that we'll incorporate from the Kickstarter community, but there may be room for more in the future. I really like the editorial at the end of the comic. Now that the first issue just got announced as sold out, anything you would like to add to this? That's a great question. However, I think my initial epilogue is still fitting. There was no way to know how this series would be received, and there is still no way to know how it will end up. Right now we are off to an amazing start, better than we could have imagined. The feedback has been 99% positive, and I think that it's genuine. My way of thanking the people that are supporting the series would be with continuing to deliver a story they find immersive. I will be doing the best to deliver on that. I know that you mentioned that you don't really read comics, but what would be your favorite one if you had to choose one? Or maybe what style of comics? There are a few scattered comics that I found to be really good. If I had to pick a favorite, I'll say the original Crow series by James Hobart. At the end of the first issue, there's a family tree that is that describes what in the clans. Any new characters might be added to this? I have a spreadsheet of over 60 characters right now. Some existed earlier in the timeline before Squires number 1, some come in many generations later. The tree in the back of the book is a very small snapshot of a few of the characters who are important early in the series. What's in the future for Squires, since I read that it was planned to be only a 4-issue miniseries? Squires will be an ongoing series, but it is being released in 4-issue block. If people continue to have interest in the book, you can expect the series to go for many, many seasons. So that's the interview I did with Ash. So far, it's like I said, it's one of my favorite comics. If not my favorite comic, I can't wait to get issue number 2. And like you saw in the questions, it got confirmed that the first issue got sold out. So I'm pretty sure it's going to go into second printing if you were not able to get it. And I'm assuming number 2 and number 3 are going to have more printing since it's got so popular. So thank you for tuning in to Papa Bear Show. And I would really like to thank Ash for that interview. And I just have a nice day. Bye now.